you know, we both had this idea that we would be solo architects, and I remember Marion saying, oh, I've had it with partners, I don't want partners, I've worked in big firms with partners, and I said, yeah, I have a break and not go that route. And, you know, you start working together, and then you quickly realize, well, whatever you said 2 months ago probably isn't relevant anymore. We were doing really interesting projects. We found that we really enjoyed working with each other, and we shared drawing as a way of talking about a project.
And so that kind of conceptual clarity, I think, is what we both look for as a kind of essence that carries a project along, no matter how many things it goes through.
If it's like two musicians, I suppose, playing the same piece, they kind of improvise off each other.
I think, you know, in some ways we found ourselves as pioneers of this idea, saying that architecture and landscape need to be thought of together. And they've been thought of together in the Renaissance, when you think about it. There's something, at the end of the day, far more satisfying about thinking of architecture being connected to landscapes and systems and cities and infrastructure.
I think we look for the kind of the toughness of certain site constraints. We found it actually liberating.
The idea of actually recognizing that there's a topographic potential in sites, allowing you to do things that you might not do otherwise.
Yeah, we live in such a saturated visual world that what we're finding is that architecture, I think, has the capacity to connect us to the real world in a way that all the kind of proliferation of images can't.